Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to Malaysian Company Law Class, or Law 6 Stance. Since today is your first lecture, so I'm going to go through the first topic of Malaysian Company Law, which is the topic on incorporation. For this topic, you are expected to understand a few things. And once you finish the topics, you should be able to explain the concept of incorporation of company, discuss the effects of incorporation of company, and elaborate circumstances which may allow the lifting of corporate veil. This is the layout, the flow chart, or the graphical layout of what we're going to learn. So for incorporation, we're going to look into the concepts of incorporation, the effects of it, to which the effects can be seen in section 18. There will be also be effects on separate legal entity, then company unlimited capacity. Company has unlimited capacity. And then, in fact, we're looking also into the liabilities of members, as well as advantages of company. So we're going to go through that one first. Now, what is company? Company is a creation by statute. Under Section 2, Subsection 1 of the Companies Act 2016, stated here as company incorporated under the Companies Act 2016. Or under any corresponding previous law is a company. But does it really explain what does it mean by a company? It's not. But basically, it just stated that when you incorporate under Companies Act 2016 or under any other previous written law, the first one was the Companies Act 1965. So we call that a company, as long as you registered under those legislation. And Section 9 of the Companies Act 2016 says that a company shall have a name, one or more members. So if it's just one member, also you can register as a company. Compared to the legislation of 1965, you require two members. But for Companies Act 2016, when you have one member, you can also incorporate a company. So basically, company shall have one or more member, having limited or unlimited liability for the obligations of the company, and in the case of company limited by shares, one or more shares. So if it's a company limited by shares, you have at least one share, compared to company limited by guarantee, there's no shares. Okay, and then one or more directors, depending on the types of the company. So basically, these are sort of like the characteristic of a company. It can be anything, it can be just one member or one or more directors. And then we're going to know about what is the concepts of incorporation. What does it mean by incorporation? So incorporation means the process of forming or creating a corporation. But then again, the terms itself does not really tells what is a company. So it is actually a creation by the statute of a types of a business organization. Now, under section 14, subsection 1 says that a person who desires to form a company shall apply for an incorporation to the registrar. So if you wanted to incorporate a company, that's a proper term we're going to use. You shall apply for application. You shall apply to the registrar to incorporate the company. And then bear in mind, under the same section, section 14, subsection 2, company shall not be formed for any unlawful purpose. So basically, if you were to incorporate company to do drug dealing, that is not allowable. So as long as it is lawful business is allowable. And then basically, section 14 itself, if you look further, section 14 subsection 3 further lay down the particulars to be included in the statement for the purpose of incorporation, such as the proposed name, status of whether the company is private or public in nature of the proposed company or any other things, yeah. So basically, yeah, for current application, yeah, you can just apply using the super form under the My COID 2016. Yeah. So it is a very basic, simple software. Actually, is in the website, yeah, of the Suruhanjaya Syarikat Malaysia of Companies Corporation, Companies Commission of Malaysia. Yeah. So you have to register your company, and normally it is done by the company secretary. So they use the My COID, My Company ID. So it is just a gateway to enable registration for the companies to be done in one day. Previously, if you look at the history, or those who wants to incorporate company, they have to go through at least minimum of 3 months before their company can be registered. But now, within a day, if you apply in the morning, probably in the afternoon, it's all approved. And then section 15, if you look at the Act, Companies Act, which I've asked all of you to download the Act from the SSM website, section 15 says that notice of registration will be issued if registrar satisfied the application has complied with the necessary requirement. And further to that, section 19 of the same Act says that the notice itself, the notice of registration is the conclusive evidence that all requirements have been complied with by the company. So it is very important for you to get the notice of registration. Now, under the 2016 Act, we don't have the Certificate of Incorporation, compared to the Companies Act 1965. So, Companies Act 2016 only requires a notice of registration. However, you can apply for the Certificate of Incorporation by paying certain amount of fees to the registrar, and then you're going to get your Certificate of Incorporation. Most companies prefer to have one copy because I believe certain organization, they requires you a copy of the certificate, not only the notice of registration but certificate. But thing is, legally, Companies Act 2016 has already stated that section 19 confirm that the notice of registration is a conclusive evidence that requirements have been complied by the company. Once you have incorporated a company, basically the company will be recognized as an artificial legal person or legal persona. This is stated by KFJ, Justice J, Justice KF, in the case of Re Sheffield and South Sheffield Yorkshire Permanent Building Society, where he said that the legal fiction of the company is legal persona just as much as individual. So basically, when you incorporate a company, there exists an individual having legal entity. So once incorporated, it can only be disembodied through the process of law. So you incorporate through process of law. If you want to close it, you must also, or disembodied, or you want to wind up, it must also be through the process of law. Now, the moment you incorporate a company, there are some effects to the incorporation. Now, first effects is section, pursuant to section 18, and the other effects are having separate legal entity, and the next one is company having unlimited capacity and liability of members. Now, we look through one by one first. The first one, which is effects pursuant to the section 18, whereby the moment you incorporate a company, the company will have a name and registration number. Then the company also have members in the register of members. So those who are registered in the company is called members. And if they have shares in the register, we call them shareholders. And those who does not have register shares, something like companies limited by guarantee, we call them members. So basically, if your name is in the register of members, you are a member of the company. Now, if you have shares, you are called shareholders. Yeah. Now, the other effects is that the company have share capital. This one is for the every person whose name stated in the application for incorporation becomes a shareholder, depending on the types of company. Yeah? Now, and then there will be details of registered office, okay, and as well as there will be a person name as the director or secretary. And basically, once you name them, they have been deemed to be appointed to that office. So meaning once you appoint them, they are deemed to be the directors of the company and also deemed to be the secretary of the company. Okay, this is the effects pursuant to section 18. Alright, now so basically section 18 is actually lists down the administrative effects compared to the other effects. Now we look into the next effects, which is the separate legal entity. But before we move on to separate legal entity, you need to understand corporate veil. What is corporate veil? The moment a company is incorporated, the veil of the company will be dropped. So basically, you drop the veil, so it will be a totally legal concept of company, whereby the company, the veil will actually separate the members and the company, and basically the company's debts and liabilities are solely belongs to the company, and the members are not liable for the company's debts and liability. That is one of the advantages of incorporating a company. Okay, so now this is relevant to separate legal entity, because the once the veil is dropped, the company having its own personal its own legal personnel compared to the original person who actually opened up the company. Now, this particular separate legal entity actually initially comes from the case of Salomon and Salomon. Now, look at this case. So, this doctrine of legal separate legal entity is derived from the case of Salomon and Salomon, where the court had established a principle that a company and its members are separate. So remember the veil just now, the veil drops to separate the company from its members. Okay, so members or officers in the company cannot be made liable to the company's debts and liabilities. Now this is compared to the business types such as the partnership or sole proprietorship, where the partners and or the owners of the owners of the business solely or jointly or severally liable, jointly liable for the debts and liabilities. Okay, for this company, the members are not liable to the company's debts and liabilities. Now, in this case, in the case of Salomon and Salomon, so Mr. Salomon, a trader engaged in the business of bootmaking, he later formed a company called Salomon and Company. At that time, in UK, the governing law was Companies Act 1862, which requires a minimum of 7 members to form a company. So the shares were subscribed by Aaron, his wife, and his 5 children. Okay, so Salomon's wife and children held their shares as Salomon nominees, basically. So Salomon and his 2 sons were appointed directors. So what happened then? Salomon sold his business, okay, to the company for £39,000, and company paid Mr. Salomon £20,000 fully paid shares of 20,000 unit of £1 per shares, and partly in the form of £10,000 of debenture. So what is debenture? Debenture is something like a document shows the indebtedness of a company. So this debenture is secured by floating charge on its asset. So no worry about this charge first. We're going to look into that later. And partly in cash withdrawn from the business. So basically, these are the facts of the Salomon's case. We continue later.